Good morning to one and all. I am Bommisetty Samusaro. I am an undergrad student from Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, India. The focus of our present study is modeling and validating the spray characteristics of a coaxial wind fluid atomizer using OpenFOAM. Coming to the motivation, atomization is the process of disintegration of a liquid jet into fine particles. This process can take place either through passive or active methods. Active modes include airflow along or perpendicular to the liquid jet, electrostatic forces, and ultrasonic waves. In passive mode, there are no external forces acting on the liquid jet, encouraging it to atomize. In today's world, atomization has found its application in almost every field, from spray painting to crop dusting, from powder metallurgy to combustion engines. It uses air far too many to list them all. In terms of combustion engines, the efficiency of an atomizer design determines the combustion efficiency. Emissions of greenhouse gases and thorough mixing of oxidizers and fuels. There are two stages in atomization process. First one is primary atomization, then secondary atomization. In the primary atomization, the liquid jet is broken up into struts and ligaments. In secondary atomization, the struts and ligaments further disintegrate into smaller droplets. The combination of both determines the spray characteristics in terms of droplet size and velocity distributions. The finer the spray, then the more stable combustion, thereby which reduces NOx emission. Coming to research gap. These are some of the research papers that are analyzed for the present study. The first paper is a numerical simulation of an air blast atomizer using OpenFOAM software is performed by Shafi et al. To evaluate the effects of geometric parameters and flow conditions on spray characteristics of the jet, it is observed that at a specific Weber number, the shorter mean diameter increases with an increase in liquid pore diameter. But for a higher Weber number, this parameter has little to no effect on the shorter mean diameter. From the second paper, an experimental study on the spray characteristics of an air-assisted atomizer with internal mixing chamber was done by Pipitpong et al. And in this paper, a twin fluid air-assist prompt atomization was used, and length of the mixing chamber and the air velocities were varied to determine the effects on atomization. In the third paper, it is seen that the diameter and the pressure at which the liquid is injected by the atomizer dictates the spray characteristics. It was determined through numerical simulations done by Anseler et al. That smaller injection diameter corresponds to a shorter breakup length, while larger injection pressure increases the penetration length of the spray. From the fourth paper, an experimental study on area void fraction associated with twin fluid atomizer was done by Sivadas et al. The present study evolves under primary breakup criteria. The computational model is going to validate by using the experimental data from this paper. Further details are shown in the upcoming slides. Problem description and scope. Atomization has a wide range of applications. One of its uses is found in combustion engines. The increase in efficiency of the atomizer design leads to various advantages such as decrease in emission of pollutants, better combustion properties. In order to reach better efficiencies, the atomization process for different designs has been studied. There have not much numerical investigations in the area of spray atomization. Most studies have been experimental. The scope of the present work is to design, analyze, and validate a computational model against the experimental results by Sivadas et al. 2013 for the liquid jet breakup length. Objective of the study. The study involves simulating the computational domain in an open source software OpenFOAM and modifying the parameters to validate the computational model with the experimental data. In addition, the study also aims to find the breakup length for different fluids. Methodology. Analyzing the data from the research paper Sivadas et al. To find out the computational dimensions and the injector diameters. Requirement of the computational domain. Then creating the model and machine. Selection of the solver in the OpenFOAM. Modifying the solver for the present study to the initial conditions used in the experimental setup. Analyzing the errors and rectifying. Results are analyzed and conducted. Experimental setup. This diagram on the left displays geometric design of the coaxial twin fluid atomizer used by the author Sivadas et al. 2013 in their experimental study. The block diagram on the right describes the experimental setup used by them. Computational domain. In our study, the working fluid is water and air. This is the diagram of the geometry of twin fluid atomizer, where red color area is water inlet and diameter is 3 mm, whereas the blue color area is air inlet and the annular area is from 9 mm to 12 mm diameter, and the yellow color represents the walls. In the present study, we are varying the water and air velocities from 0.7 to 1.8 meter per second and 19 to 31.3 meter per second. Mesh. Coming to mesh, the computational domain width was designed at a width of 20 times the diameter of the water injector. This was based on the study by the effect of nozzle diameter, which determined that a width of 16 to 32 times the diameter would be ideal. Hence, our computational domain measures 60 by 60 by 180 millimeters. The computational domain is measured fine at its core and is porous towards its periphery. This is done so as to minimize the number of mesh elements present in the domain, thereby reducing the computational time. The mesh independency test is conducted, and further increase or decrease in mesh elements doesn't affect the accuracy of our results. The element type which we used in the mesh is hexahedral. Boundary conditions. The boundary conditions were given for the walls, air, and water inlet. Coming to air inlet, the fixed value for velocity, fixed flux pressure for pressure, and for alpha dot water, it is calculated as 0. Whereas for water inlet, it will be fixed value for velocity, fixed flux pressure for pressure, alpha dot water is calculated as 1. For walls, there will be no slip condition for velocity. It is a 0 gradient for pressure, and alpha dot water will be fixed value. For outlet, 0 gradient for both velocity and alpha dot water. Total pressure is calculated as 1 atmospheric pressure. Coming to phase properties, the density of the water and air is tabulated, and the surface tension is 0.07 Newton per meter at 25 degrees centigrade. In the present study, we use the K epsilon model as the turbulence model, and the gravity is in minus y direction. Numerical simulation. In the present study, we have used the Reynolds average Navier-Stokes equation and volume of fluid method. These are governing equations used by the solver for the present simulations. First one is constant density continuity equation, second is momentum equation, and third is interface equation. Coming to discretization schemes, we used the first order Eulerian for transient terms, second order Gaussian for other terms in the equation. We had used the Pimple algorithm for pressure velocity coupling. The simulation is conducted for time period of 0.3 seconds and the maximum Courant number as 0.5. Coming to the results, by using the Eulerian and VYF framework, we are able to predict the interface between the two fluids, and the breakup length can be identified. The animation is shown for water and air velocities of 1.8 and 31.3 meter per second respectively, where the breakup length can be visualized. Coming to contour plots, the top contour plot is the velocity plot for which water and air velocities are 0.7 and 31.3 meter per second respectively. From the plot, we can observe that how water is getting affected by the air, which has higher velocity compared to the water, and water velocity is getting reduced with respect to the control volume length. Because of the interaction between the air and water, the liquid jet is breaking into spray. The below contour plot for the alpha dot water, that is concentration of the water, the value varies from 0 to 1, whereas 0 represents the water is not present, and 1 represents the water is present. The breakup length is found out to be 24.6 mm. These contour plots for velocity of water and air is 1.8 and 19 meter per second respectively. For the velocity plot, the velocity variation of the fluids can be visualized. Because of the air interaction on the water, the velocity of water is gradually reducing. The below contour plot tells the breakup length of the spray, and the breakup length is 137 millimeters. Coming to breakup length comparison plot. The breakup length is plotted against the water velocities with constant air velocities. From the plot, we can observe that the breakup is increasing by increasing the water velocity for both experimental values and the simulation value. The experimental data has an uncertainty of plus or minus 20%. For the left plot, where air velocity is 19 meter per second, the minimum, maximum, and average uncertainty of the simulation values from the experimental values is 3.3%, 34.2%, 16.4% respectively. For the right plot, where air velocity is 22.4%, the minimum and maximum and average uncertainty is found out to be 5.8%, 20%, 18.9% respectively. For the left plot, where air velocity is 24.5 meter per second, the minimum, maximum and average uncertainty for the simulation values is 6.3%, 32.2%, 23.8% respectively. For the right plot, where air velocity is 29 meter per second, the minimum uncertainty is 3.4%, maximum is 31.4% and average is 21.1%. On the left plot, where air velocity is 31.3%, the minimum, maximum and average uncertainty for the simulation values is 6.5%, 31.9% and 21.7% respectively. The right plot for all the right plot has all the 25 cases which we have simulated, where the black line represents the simulation data and red line represents the experimental data. From this plot, we can observe that the simulation data followed the same trend as the experimental data. That is, at constant air velocity, as water velocity increases, the breakup length increases. At constant water velocity, as air velocity increases, the breakup length decreases. By analyzing all the 25 simulation data, the minimum maximum average uncertainty from the experimental data is 3.3%, 34.2% and 20% respectively. Comparison breakup length with the relative mass flow rate. One of the parameters that was calculated and analyzed was the relative mass flow rate between water and the air. In the scatter plot shown, the relative mass flow rate is plotted against the liquid breakup lengths. It can be observed that the breakup length increases with increase in relative mass flow rate. The relative mass flow rate is an important parameter, since if the value is low, it means the mass flow rate of air is high enough for the aerodynamic shear effect to break up the liquid. When the value is high, mass flow rate of water is high enough that the aerodynamic shear effect is not enough and the surface tension breakup model takes more importance in the breakup model observed. We are concluding that in this study, the breakup lengths were observed and calculated numerically. By considering the ligaments and the droplets formed due to atomization as a continuous fluid, it helped in identifying the breakup length more accurately. This was achieved through the use of Eulerian VOF solver that modeled the fluid as continuum. This model was able to calculate the breakup length with an average of 20% of uncertainty from the experimental data. In general, as the velocity of water increases, the breakup length increases. As the velocity of air increases, the breakup length decreases. As the relative mass flow rate increases, the breakup length increases. Coming to future perspective, using the successfully validated computational model, we would like to extend our area of study in the forthcoming future to the study of spray characteristics of a coaxial swirl atomizer. Initially, it would be simulated with a working medium of water and air, while it would be later be changed from a working medium of aviation fluid and air with a possibility of introducing combustion conditions. In the figure displayed, the initial simulations for the conditions of air velocity 19 meter per second, water velocity 1.8 meter per second, and the swirl vane angle is 30 degrees. Where simulated for 0.02 seconds and displayed here. These are some of the references that we had used during the course of our study. Thank you.